In this video, we would talk about how to import a survey data into NVivo Mac. So to do so, we will go to Data, and we would go to Dataset. So here is Dataset, and we would go for the Excel sheet. So in my computer, it is on desktop. And it is in 2 days NVivo course, and it's here. So let's see, it's a survey data. So let's add this one. So it will ask me for the Excel file you have selected contain multiple worksheets. Select the one you would like to import. So we can import metadata or table one. So let's import metadata. If I click on this, it will only import this data, the one which is linked to table one. But I would click on metadata and click next. Now here, I have an option that I can keep these on or off. Let's see if I make it as row ID or as ABCD. Let's go to the next one. Here I have the option. You can specify information about each fields you are importing. Select the fields in the data preview area below. You can then modify fields information in the field option area. So if I want, I can, this one, I can select it or I can deselect all. So if I deselect all, it would not appear. But if I select it, so it would come up. So that's how you can import. And when I selected it, it also came here. So I can import field or I can not import field. There is a codable field and classifying field, and data type is text. So see, when I change it, it will also change this. Anyhow, let's import all of it. So I will go next, and this is all. It will import the whole file. Once it is imported, I can see the file under files. So here we can see the Excel file in the file area. However, we cannot see any case classification attached to it or any cases attached to it. So in order to, but we can also run an autocode on this data. So to do so, we would right click on the Excel file and check autocode, and we would say autocode dataset. Now we have two options, either to code at node for selected columns or to code at cases for each value in a column, or we can repeat the same process and do it once for code nodes and again go back to the Excel file and do it for cases. And it's simple and easy. So we would go next and choose the column that contains the case names. So here we can say row ID or let's say by respondents. And these are the respondents. If we say row ID, then we are getting 1, 2, 3, 4. But let's get it with the respondents name, respondents. And then we would get next. Now, we would keep it the way it is because we can make it some columns and leave the other columns over here by selecting it this way. So for example, if we want only these columns, we can move some of them here and then it would not be part of it. But in our case, we want all of them to be selected. So let's go next. Now here it could be select the autocode location. So it could be under a new case, or we could keep it under existing case. Let's keep it under new case. And the case location, we can also find that under cases. It would be there. It would be called Excel file. That is the name of this file. And then we can say aggregate coding from child codes and classify cases for classifying columns. And then it can create new classification for us. And we can also use the existing case classification. Let's say we call it survey data. And if we say so, we would call it survey data. And let's autocode it. We can also select or deselect some items from here. So for example, if we don't want a place of development, we can make it dull, and that would not be part of this survey data. Now let's press on autocode. And now we can see that this file has autocoded. If we go to cases, we can see that the cases are all here under cases. And if we go to case classification, we can see that the survey data is here with all the, and if we click on here, we get the attributes and the classification sheet as a whole. Now, if we want, we can assign our data. If one of these people is Margaret, we can go to files, and we could go to Barbara, and we can that's a different. In order to do that, we have to make them to cases first. So we have to make them to create as cases, for example, and then go to cases and then select Barbara and assign her, go to classification and give her a survey data. But then we have to identify. So for example, here we have given that Barbara a survey data, give her, we can assign stuff to her. So for example, in these values, if we look, we can say township, and we can give her Harker Island, and we can give her row ID. And double click on this and click on magnifying glass and give her, like, for example, row ID 2 and update, and similarly a few others and update.
This is the end of importing Excel file into NVivo Mac.